Hello friends, I know a lot of you have an obsession with sciencey things in life, and I think you're in for a treat. Today, we're going to be taking a look at some viruses that are quite hard to come by these days, and I promise you, you'll be glad that they are when you hear about the horrible symptoms they can cause. My name is Danny Burke, and this is the top 10 rarest viruses found in humans, part 2. Coming out of the number 10 spot now, we have the Hantavirus. This virus usually begins in rodents and is often transmitted to humans through mice feces. So, if you don't know this already, please stay away from all mouse poo. It first gained attention in 1993 when a healthy Native American man in the US died from the virus just a few days after saying he had a shortness of breath. Since then, 600 people have died from it in the US alone, so it is pretty rare. However, there have been reports from South America of the virus being transmitted from human to human, so perhaps staying away from mice feces isn't even enough anymore. Next up at number 9 now, we have rabies. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. Rabies? I've heard of rabies. That can't be rare. Well, it's a lot rarer than it used to be. This viral disease causes an inflammation of the brain in mammals. It's spread to humans when an infected animal scratches or bites them, although saliva can also transmit it too. The most common infections in humans come from dogs and bats. Rabies kills about 17,000 people a year, but 95% of those occur in Africa and Asia, so it's not a global issue at the moment. Thanks to vaccination and prevention programs around the world, more and more countries are becoming rabies free. At the number 8 spot now, we have Hepatitis A. This is caused by the Hepatitis A virus. Symptoms last about 8 weeks and include nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, jaundice, fever, and abdominal pain. These symptoms affect about 1.4 million people a year, which isn't that much compared to how bad it used to be. For example, in the US alone, the number of cases has dropped from around 117,000 a year to just 11,000 a year in 2013. There is still obviously work to be done in developing countries though. Next up at number 7 now, we have smallpox. In the 20th century alone, smallpox killed an estimated 300 million people. It's been one of the deadliest viruses humanity has ever known. Thanks to a massive international effort, the World Health Organization declared that smallpox had been completely eradicated in the world in 1979. Since then, not a single person has died from it. However, there are still 2 samples of the virus left. One is being held by the US and one by Russia. The purpose is to study them in a safe laboratory setting. This makes it an extremely rare virus, although it is thought that Iraq, North Korea, and France also have their own samples. Coming in at number 6 now, we have the Lassa virus. This one is carried by a species of rat in West Africa. However, it's also airborne, which means people get infected just being around rat feces. It's pretty lethal, with a 15 to 20% mortality rate, causing about 5,000 deaths a year in West Africa. Symptoms include fever, chest pain, facial swelling, bleeding, and even deafness. Researchers are looking to eradicate the virus, though, with drugs that tackle the early stages of infection. Moving on to number 5 now, we have Rubella. This virus is highly contagious and its symptoms are most brutal in fetuses during a mother's pregnancy. A fetus with Rubella can develop deafness, blindness, and severe brain damage. In adults, it's usually just a skin rash and cold-like symptoms. An outbreak in the US in the 1960s caused 11,250 abortions, 2,100 stillborns, and 20,000 babies born with defects. In 2015, Rubella was declared eliminated from the Americas, although it still affects about 120,000 children a year in the rest of the world. Next up at the number 4 spot now, we have polio. Historically, this virus has been a global problem, affecting millions of people over the years. It doesn't cause any visible symptoms in most people though, but in 1% of cases, it leaves sufferers with permanent physical disabilities. Of those people, about 5 to 10% of them die when the muscles involved in breathing just stop working. Since 1988, cases of polio have dropped 99%, and just 3 countries, Nigeria, Pakistan, and Afghanistan, still report cases of it today. Coming in at number 3 now, we have mumps. This virus spawns a contagious disease that causes the salivary glands in your cheeks and jaw to swell up. Symptoms include headaches, muscle aches, fatigue, and loss of appetite. Sometimes it can even cause more serious problems such as a swelling of the brain. Right up to the 1960s, this was a very serious problem in countries such as the US. An outbreak in 1964 affected over 212,000 people. Today though, thanks to vaccinations. Mumps affects just a few thousand people in the US every year, with other countries reporting similar rates. Alright, at the number 2 spot now, we have Hepatitis B. As you might expect from the name, the Hepatitis B virus is related to the Hepatitis A virus. It causes a quick sickness that involves vomiting, yellow skin, tiredness, dark urine, and abdominal pain. It's transmitted via infected blood or other bodily fluids. Now, thanks to a vaccination that became available in 1982, the virus has become a lot rarer than it used to be, although it still kills over 750,000 people worldwide every single year. And finally, at number 1 now, we have the Crimean-Congo haemorrhagic fever. This is a pretty deadly virus, with outbreaks seeing a 40% fatality rate. It's transmitted to humans through bites from ticks that have previously bitten infected animals. It can also be transmitted from human to human through blood. Symptoms include fevers, muscle aches, dizziness, neck pains, headaches, and sensitivity to light. The virus still affects many people across Africa and Asia, but is limited in where it can travel to because of the ticks that it needs for transmission. Its frequency tends to drop sharply the further north you go. Guys, will we ever be able to stop viruses altogether, like we did with smallpox? Maybe. Some people think the viruses will always just adapt, and it's a war that we simply cannot win. I'm quite optimistic though. What do you guys think? And what do you want to see next on the channel? My name is Danny Burke. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.